everyone. Myself Sneha Shah from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology from the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. Today I am going to explain you topics two-dimensional discrete random variable and two-dimensional discrete random variable distribution function from the unit of basic probability from the subject of probability and statistics. Up to last session, I had explained you one random variable x. We have defined the continuous random variable and the discrete random variable. Now, in this session, I will explain you for two-dimensional random variable x and y. So, starting with two-dimensional discrete random variable. Let x and y be the two random variable defined on the same sample space S. The function x, y that assigns a point in R square is called a two-dimensional random variable. When x, y is a two-dimensional discrete random variable, the possible values of x and y may be represented as xi, yj, where the value of I equals to 1, 2, 3 up to m and the value of j equals to 1, 2, 3 up to n. So in this, the value of x may be different from the value of y, right? So we are taking the different values of I and j. So in general, it will representing as xi and yj. Now the next term is joint probability mass function. As you know that we have taken two dimension random variable. It means we have taken two different random variables x and y. So for this, the value of probability mass function is considered as joint. And as you know that we are taking the discrete random variable, so the function for this will consider as probability mass function. And suppose if we are taking for the continuous random variable, so for that we are taking probability density function. And similarly, if we are taking the two-dimensional random variable, so for that we are taking joint probability density function for the continuous random variable. Okay. So, joint probability mass function can be defined for a two-dimensional discrete random variable as probability xy of xi, yj equals to joint probability of x and y. It means probability of x equals to xi and y equals to yj. And this should satisfy the following condition, then and then only it will consider as probability mass function. So the first condition is probability xy of xi, yj, this should be greater than or equals to 0 for every I and j. It means the value of probability should be greater than or equals to 0, means the value of probability should be positive number for every values of I and j. Now the second condition is summation of probability of x equals to 1. Similarly, here we have taken two random variables x and y. So for that we have to take two summations. The first summation is for x and the second condition is for y. So we are taking summation of j equals to 1 to n. The summation I equals to 1 to n pxy of xi, yj, this should be equals to 1. So the summation of all the probability should be equals to 1. So if any function satisfying these two conditions, then and then only it will consider as the joint probability mass function. Now the next topic is cumulative distribution function. Now what is the meaning of cumulative distribution function? Cumulative means up to some point, if we are calculating the dense distribution function for that, so it will consider as cumulative distribution function. So if we are defining this, so it is given by fxy x, y is equals to probability of x is less than or equals to x, y is less than or equals to 1. This equals to summation j equals to 1 to n, summation I equals to 1 to n, pxy of xi, yj is equals to summation pij. Because in general, this two will be considered as summation, and this probability will be represented as Pij. So the first term is for x and the second term is for y. Now the properties of this cumulative distribution function are, the first condition is f of minus infinite comma y equals to 0 is equals to f of x comma infinite. It means for minus infinite term, it is considered as impossible event, so its probability equals to 0, so the function of this equals to 0. And if we're taking function of infinite comma infinite means the whole range, so in this range definitely it will occur in that particular event, so it will consider as the certain event, and as it is certain event, so its probability equals to 1, and as this function is defining as a probability function, so it will consider as function of this equals to 1. Now the second property is probability of x in between a to b and y is less than or equals to y, means we are taking the all the values of y and the value of x in particular range, so the function will be representing as f of b comma y minus function a comma y, because we are taking higher value of x minus lower value of x and we are taking for the entire range of y. Similarly, if we are finding the value of probability of x is less than or equals to x, now we are taking the entire range of x but for a particular value of y in between c to d. So the function will be for entire x, means x comma d minus f of x comma c. It means the higher value of y minus the lower value of y and the for the entire range of x. Now the next topic is marginal probability function. Now what is marginal probability function? From the two-dimensional random variable, means from x and y, if you want to find for only x and for only y, so it will be fine by using the marginal probability function. So suppose if we are finding for only x, so it will be defining as px of xi, so its value will be considered as probability of x equals to xi. Now we are finding the probability of x only from the two-dimensional random variable by probability of x equals to xi comma y equals to y1 plus probability of x equals to xi comma y equals to y2 up to the last term is probability of x equals to xi comma y equals to yn. It means for a particular value of x, we are taking the different values of y and we are taking the summation of all these terms, so it will give you the term as probability of x for particular term xi. Now this will be representing as pi1 because the first term representing for the value of x, and the value of x is considered as xi. The value of y1 means 1, so the term will be pi1 plus pi2 plus up to last term is pim. So this one is the representation. Now this can be representing in the form of summation as summation j equals to 1 to m bij. So instead of 1, 2, 3 up to m terms, we will taking the summation form. So it will representing as summation of j equals to 1 to m bij. Now this can be also representing as summation of j equals to 1 to m p of xi comma yj. So from this two-dimensional random variable, we can find out the value of probability of x equals to xi, means the marginal probability. And this can be also representing as pi star. It means for a particular value of x, but for the different values of y. Similarly, if we are finding py of yj, then its value will be p of y equals to yj. And its value will be summation I equals to 1 to n pij. Here instead of pi star we will write in p star j. So the term will be p star j, and the equation can be also representing as summation I equals to 1 to n probability of xi comma yj. So in this two equation you can see that if we want to find out the value of probability of x, so we have to take the summation of all the terms of j. It means the values of y. And if we want to find out probability of y, so we have to take the summation of I. It means all the values of x but for a fixed value of y. Okay, so this way we can find out the value of marginal probability function. Now the next topic is conditional probability function. Now what is conditional probability function? Suppose any one term is given to you and you have to find out the probability of another term. Like if you want to find out probability of x given y. So for that we are taking probability of x given y of x given y. So its value will be probability of x given y in bracket x equals to x given y equals to y. Now as you know that what is the equation of conditional probability? Its value will be probability of A given B. Suppose if I am writing probability of A given B, so you will write as probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B, right? Similarly, here also I will take like probability of X equals to X comma Y equals to Y. Means joint probability of X and Y divided by probability of Y equals to Y. Provided that probability of y equals to y, this should not equals to 0. It means the denominator should not be equals to 0. Similarly, if we are finding probability of y given x of y given x, so its value will be probability of y given x in bracket y equals to y given x equals to x. So its value will be probability of x equals to x comma probability of y equals to y divided by probability of x equals to x. Here, provided probability of x equals to x should not be equals to 0 because the denominator should not be equals to 0. Why? Because if we are taking the denominator equals to 0, so it will consider as infinite probability. And as you know that the value of probability can't be infinite. The maximum value of the probability equals to 1. So we can't take the value of probability of x equals to 0 for this particular thing and probability of y equals to y equals to 0 for this equation. In the next session, I will explain you the example based on this two-dimensional discrete random variable and its functions examples. Thank you so much.